Welcome again for the course on micro irrigation organized by ICID. To this chapter 6, lecture 2, which is the subject is drip irrigation system design. In the first chapter, we have seen various recommendations, what is design, what is good design, and all that. In this chapter, we will be looking at actual design formulas, design steps, and one live example. In the design of drip irrigation system, we will be looking at application rate, shape, shape duration, shape areas, shape flows, crop water requirement or peak water requirement. So to understand these terminologies, I have shown in a different way. We have seen this man in the previous lectures, last slide. So he is walking at say a speed of 5 kilometers per hour. That is the speed of his walking. Similarly, in irrigation, drip irrigation system design, we are giving irrigation at certain speed, that is called as the application rate. So walking speed is compared, or for understanding, it is compared with the application rate. Then he need to travel the 20 kilometer. Similarly, what is the amount of irrigation we need to give? So the distance is compared with the amount of water to be given for the meeting the crop water requirement. And then what is the time required to cover this distance, 20 km for this man at the speed of 5 km per hour. So time of irrigation is calculated or considered depending on the rate at which we are giving the irrigation and what is the amount of water to be given. So just for understanding, rate of irrigation is compared with the speed, walking speed of this man. The distance to be covered, that is compared with the crop water requirement, and time required to walk this distance is compared with the time of irrigation, that is called as a shift duration. So how to calculate this application rate? Application rate is nothing but the application of water per unit time expressed in depth, that is in millimeters. The unit of the application rate is millimeters per hour. So rate of irrigation depends on the dripper specifications. What is the dripper discharge? What is the dripper to dripper spacing? And what is the lateral spacing? The application is derived from these dripper or emitting pipe specifications. The application rate is calculated based on this formula: dripper discharge into number of laterals per row divided by dripper spacing into row spacing. Say there is an example. There is 1 liters per hour flow rate, and the number of laterals given for each row of crop is 1, and dripper to dripper spacing is 0.4 meter, and dripper and lateral to lateral spacing is say 1.5 meters. So in this case, the application rate is calculated as 1 into 1 divided by 0.4, that is the dripper spacing, and divided by 1.5 meters, that is the lateral spacing. So ultimately the final value is 1.66 millimeter per hour. So if we are giving irrigation with dripper specifications of 1 liter dripper at every 40 centimeter, and if the drip line spacing is 1.5 meter, we are giving irrigation at the rate of 1.66 millimeter per hour. There are different types of drippers, pressure compensated and non-pressure compensated. You must have seen in the product lectures, but still there is one slide on this topic. Pressure compensated drippers, the dripper discharge is constant irrespective of the inlet pressure to this emitter. In case of non-pressure compensated drippers, the dripper discharge is depends on the inlet pressure to the dripper. So that is the basic difference. In terms of non-pressure compensated drippers, we use the term permissible length. Generally, for the flow variation of 7.5%, what is the length of drip line? That is called as a permissible length of specific flow rate of emitting pipe. And inlet pressure, that is the terminology used for the pressure compensated drippers, because the flow there is no flow variation within the emitting pipe in case of pressure compensated drippers. Shift is nothing but the block or several blocks that are irrigated simultaneously by the same water source during the irrigation cycle. Suppose there is an area of 10 hectare. So generally we do not irrigate entire 10 hectare in a single shift or at a time, depending on the water source availability of the flow, and to meet or to have the cost optimum design, we divide that area into more number of shifts. So depending on the flow rate, if say flow rate is, available flow rate is 20 cubic meters per hour, then we need to divide these areas into small units to have balance between the available flow rate and the design flow rate. Shift duration, that is the time of irrigation, that is calculated as the peak water requirement divided by application rate. Example, say we need to give, or the crop water requirement is say 4 millimeters per day, and we are giving the irrigation at the rate of 1.66 millimeters per hour, then we need to irrigate to meet the crop water requirement, we need to irrigate for 2.4 hours. Shifts per day, that is the number of sections can be done in total area. Shifts per day can be calculated based on the maximum operating hours per day divided by shift duration, that is the time of irrigation of one shift. Example, they say there are 12 operating hours per day, and with this example, if the shift duration is 2.4 hours, then maximum 5 shifts we can have. Shift area, that is the area irrigated at a time. Shift flows, that is the flow rate of one small shift area, that can be calculated depending on the this formula, area per shift into application rate into 10. If the area per shift is in hectare, then that multiplication factor is 10. If we consider the area in acres, then this multiplication factor is 4. So from where this factor is coming? To explain that, you can refer the right side figure. 1 millimeter depth of water on 1 meter square area, that is nothing but the 1 liter. Similarly, 1 millimeter depth of water on 1 hectare area, 1 hectare is nothing but the 10,000 square meters. So 1 millimeter depth of water on 1 hectare area, or 10,000 meter square, is nothing but the 10,000 liters, which is equal to 10 cubic meters. So that 10 factor is coming. When the area is an acre, 1 acre is nothing but the 4047 meter squares. So 1 millimeter depth of water on 1 acre area, that is 4047 liters, or around 4 cubic meters. So when the area is in hectare, the multiplication factor is 10. When the area is in acre, the multiplication factor is 4. For example, what is the shift flow for the total area of 10 hectares to be irrigated in 4 shifts? And the dripper specifications are 1 lps dripper at every 40 centimeters, and the lateral spacing is 1.5 meter. The application rate is the same example. So application rate is 1 divided by dripper spacing divided by lateral spacing, that is 1.66 millimeter per hour. Shift area, as mentioned here, we need to irrigate in 4 shifts. So the total area divided by 4, that is the shift area, 2.5 hectare is the shift area. Then shift flow can be calculated as area in hectares into application rate in millimeters per hour into 10, that is the multiplication factor. So the shift flow is 41.6 meter cube per hour in this example. So this can be cross verified with the another method. Emitting pipe required to cover the 1 hectare area, that can be calculated based on the area in meter square divided by emitting pipe spacing. So in this case, the distance between the lateral is 1.5 meter and area is say 1 hectare. So 10,000 divided by 1.5. So each hectare needs around 6,667 meter of drip line, or the emitting pipe. As mentioned, the dripper spacing is 40 centimeters. Then the number of drippers in 1 hectare will be around 16,666 numbers. The dripper flow rate is 1 lph. So dripper flow rate for the total area, 1 hectare area, will be 16,666 liters per hour. That is nothing but the 16.6 meter cube per hour. Now our shift area is 2.5 hectare and flow rate of 1 hectare is 16.6 meter cube per hour. So the shift flow rate, total shift flow rate, will be 2.5 into 16.6, that is 41.6 meter cube per hour. So this is just cross verification of the formula. Then this is the complete irrigation data. On the design drawing, at the end of the design, we need to give all this information. That is, what is the area, what is the crop considered into design, and what is the irrigation system proposed, whether it is a drip or sprinkler or micro sprinkler or center pivot. Then what is the emitter used, whether it is PC or non-PC or any specific product. Then what is the emitter flow rate considered into design, what is the dripper to dripper spacing, what is the lateral spacing considered into design. Then what is the rate of irrigation, that is the application rate. What is the peak water requirement considered into design? Then what is shift duration, available operating hours per day? And then depending on the available operating hours per day and shift duration, what is the number of shifts per day as per design? Then what is the average shift areas, average shift flows? What is the maximum discharge variation in the design? What is the water source? All these information should be given onto design drawing to have better understanding whoever refers the design drawing. So this is the final design drawing. As I said, we need to give the maximum details on the design drawing for the easy understanding. So we can give the location map from the Google Earth. Then there should be design notes. What is the submain used? What are the diameters used for the mainline design? What are the pressure classes of the pipes? Are there any safety equipment proposed into the design? What is the total pumping head arrived at the end of design? What is the shift areas? What are the shift flows? Then we need to give the irrigation data. We need to give the operational schedule. We need to give the shift layout. If all this information is given on the drawing, it is very easy for whoever refers the drawing. It will be very easy to understand. Then the pump duty. This is the information required to recommend the pump. Pump duty is nothing but the what is the breakup of the total head arrived at, what are the parameters considered, that is like a minimum emitter operating pressure, then what is the frictional head loss considered into the emitting pipe or as per actual, what is the submain head loss, is there any elevation, then what is the wall head losses considered into design. Then field fittings, main lines, elevations, secondary filters, primary filters, fertigation equipment, water source depth, then frictional head losses in the vertical pipe of that pumping system. So considering all this, we need to arrive at the total head, and also we need to specify the discharge for the selection of right pump set which can satiate the when the project area is big, while suggesting the pump, we need to suggest more number of pumps instead of one big pump. That will give us the flexibility to irrigate even if some pump is not working. If we suggest two or three pumps, then if one is not working, we can continue irrigation with the other two or three pumps. Similarly, this gives the flexibility to irrigate the partial area. When the project area is big, it is not necessary that entire area will be under irrigation all the time. So if we suggest only one pump, then there is a loss of energy and it is waste of money and energy. So if we have more number of pumps, we can have flexibility to irrigate through one or two or three pumps instead of having wastage of energy. Then we can have pumps in parallel and pumps in series. When there is a demand for the more flow rate, then we need to have the pumps in parallel. So say there is demand of 100 cubic meters per hour and each pump is giving say 50 cubic meter per hour, then we need to have two pumps in parallel to meet the required discharge. When we are meeting the discharge but we are short of head, then we need to have the pumps in series. Suppose we need 80 meter total head and one pump is developing around 50 meters, then if we add pumps in series one after another, then we can develop the required head. Power consumption or the recurring charges. In order to have a cost effective design, we need to reduce the frictional head losses, and also we need to have the efficient pumping system, that is pumps and motors. So for the given flow rate, reduce the head and have the higher efficiency of pump and motor, that will have the lower power consumption. The energy charges can be calculated as this formula, that is the flow in liters per second into head divided by 75 into pump efficiency into drive efficiency multiplied with the unit rate of power charges. Then for the hydraulic design, at Netafim we use IRICAD software, which is flexible and intuitive tool for the hydraulic designs that contains powerful pipe sizing algorithm. With the IRICAD we can have automatic pipe sizing, also it gives the various reports, errors. It has ability to perform hydraulic analysis on large and complex systems including hydraulic loop. It is a graphical tool for specifying system operation and checking system integrity. It is ideal tool, IRICAD is ideal tool for the design of the drip irrigation systems, sprinkler irrigation systems, pressurized pipe distribution networks, including gravity pipe networks, then sports fields, golf courses, and system pressurized by gravity. Benefits of IRICAD: it is an integrated system approach that saves your time and money. Rapid analysis of complex hydraulic system that facilitates faster drawing charges, design changes, a wide range of design options. Quality presentations can be prepared with the minimal efforts, increased productivity and enhanced company image, a rapid response mechanism to your clients and changing needs. So with the IRICAD, if you prepare one design option, then easily you can have more number of options as per the client requirements and suggestions. So that creates a different impact when you meet a client with such a sophisticated design tool. IRICAD has a different tools like design parameters. We can set the recommended flow velocities to be allowed for the design. What is the flow velocity allowed for the design of mainline system? What is the flow velocity allowed for the design of submains or the bulk water supply? All these input methods are there. Then display what should be the line thickness of the main line, what should be the line thickness of submain. All these parameters can be set as per our requirement. It gives the shift-wise pump duty. It gives minimum and maximum pressure at any section of the design. It has settings of level. It gives the various reports and bombs. Then it gives the digital elevation model, 3D model. It gives the hydraulic grid lines, and various operational scenarios can be analyzed into same design. So these are some of the tools and advantages.
Welcome to IRICAD Irrigation Design Software, your all-in-one design solution. IRICAD is an integrated software platform that allows you to complete design drawings, analyze complex hydraulic calculations, and effortlessly compile design and costing reports within a single platform. This integrated approach eliminates errors and simplifies your workflow. IRICAD can be used to design any pressurized system, including drip and sprinkler irrigation, parks and landscape irrigation, and frost protection systems. It can also be used to analyze and design extensions to existing systems, making design upgrades easy and keeping your information in one place for any future changes. It includes a comprehensive suite of CAD tools customized for the easy input of pipes and components, along with graphical tools to aid in the placement of submains and mainlines. IRICAD can automatically size the pipes for you based on the required outlet valve pressures or on maximum pipe velocity to take the hard work out of manually choosing pipe sizes. Our advanced hydraulic algorithms include allowances for elevation changes and can easily be used for complex and looped systems. You can tell IRACAD how the system will run, what valves are working, then see the resulting requirements. Built into the software is a user-editable database of pipes, components, and fittings from a range of leading manufacturers, allowing for the automatic selection of fittings and generation of bills of materials. The flexible plotting functions allow for fast preparation of design drawings, including customizable automatic labeling and generation of plan legends. In addition to providing detailed tabular reports, IRACAD also generates graphical views of the hydraulic results that can be placed on the design. These easily convey information to your client, helping justify the design decisions made. You can also import data and images from Google, and then review the resulting designs in Google Earth, allowing you to predetermine any issues that may arise due to geographical challenges. To allow for cross-platform integration, you can import and export a wide range of AutoCAD, GIS, text, elevation data, and image files. IRACAD.
So in this video, it is much clear that what is the advantages of IRACAD. Drip irrigation system general design steps. So this table gives the various steps to be followed for this design of the drip irrigation system. It is starting with the farm survey questionnaire, that is the data collection. Then decide on the irrigation system, whether it is going to be drip or micro sprinkler or any other. Then decide the product to be used in the design. Then the product includes the product specifications, like what is going to be the emitter flow rates, what is going to be the lateral distances, etc. Then calculate the application rate, that is the speed at which we are going to irrigate. Calculate the shift duration, calculate the number of shifts. Then check the permissible length of the product, that is finalized, and also calculate the lateral head loss. Then divide the area considering the permissible length of the product into the various shifts and within shift as well. Then decide location of the submain, connect all walls with the water source, decide size of the submains and main lines, calculate the total head required to operate the system, suggest pump set, and at the end prepare bill of quantities. These are the general steps to be followed for the design of drip irrigation system. Let us take one example. This is the farm survey questionnaire. The right side is the farm sketch. The crop is sugarcane for this farm. The bed spacing for the sugarcane is 1.8 meter. So we need to give the drip line at every 1.8 meters. The average, the area of this farm is 10 acres. The peak water requirement for the design to be considered is 7 millimeters per day. Then time available is 13 hours. Water available is 22.5 cubic meters per hour. The water source is well with depth of 8 meter and row direction is specified as east-west. So we need to calculate the area of this farm. It is given 10 acres, but still we need to check plot-wise areas. So first we need to check, can we irrigate given area with available water in specified time? The time is given as 13 hours and available flow rate is given as 22.5 meter cube per hour. So we need to check whether it is enough to irrigate the entire area or not. So area that can be irrigated with the available water is calculated based on this formula. Area is equal to available discharge divided by peak water requirement into time. And again we need to have this a multiplication factor. If the area is an acre, the multiplication factor is 4. If the area is in a hectare, multiplication factor is 10. We need to divide with this multiplication factor to arrive at the right area. Here we are talking about the area in acre, So the formula is Q, that is the available flow rate in meter cube per hour, divided by application rate into time, and that value and the final result to be divided by 4 to arrive at the area in acres. So 22.5 divided by 7 into 13, the answer is 41.78. Again, that to be divided by 4, so 10.44 acres. So with the available water and time, we can irrigate maximum 10.44 acre area, which is more than the actual area, so we do not have problem. In the previous slide, we calculated the area that can be irrigated with the available water and given time. So in this slide, this formula gives the required discharge to irrigate the given area and for the meeting the specified crop water requirement. Now we will calculate the flow rate. Now area is given as 10 acres and the peak water requirement is given as 7 millimeters and the available time is given as 13 hours per day. So the required discharge should be around 21.5 cubic meters per hour, but the available discharge is 22.5 cubic meter per hour, which is more than the required discharge. So we can irrigate the given area with the given time comfortably. We are supposed to irrigate this area with the drip line 16008, that is the specific product of Netafim. The dripper to dripper spacing chosen is 0.5 meters, 50 centimeters, and the dripper discharge is 2.1 LPH. We are supposed to design it with the 16 millimeter lateral, and 1.8 is the drip line spacing or the row spacing, and the number of laterals per row is specified as 1. So calculation of the application rate or the rate at which we are giving the irrigation, that is calculated with this formula: dripper discharge into number of laterals per row divided by dripper spacing divided by lateral spacing. So 2.1 LPH into 1 lateral per row. The dripper spacing is 50 centimeters and lateral to lateral spacing is 1.8. So the application rate is calculated as 2.33 millimeters per hour. Shift duration. We are supposed to irrigate or give the water supply of 7 millimeters per day, and we are giving at the rate of 2.3 millimeters per hour. So the shift duration is calculated as peak water requirement divided by application rate. So the shift duration is calculated as 3 hours for each shift. Number of shifts per day, that is calculated as available operating hours per day divided by shift duration. So we have 13 hours and shift duration is 3 hours. So 13 by 3, around 4 shifts can be done. This is the given sketch of the area. The area of each unit is 2.5 acre. So maximum permissible length we need to find for the discharge variation of 7.5%. The drip line is non-pressure compensated emitting pipe. So as per the rule, we need to have maximum 10% discharge variation within the shift areas. So on the lateral, we will allow around 7.5% discharge variation, and the balance 2.5% margin will be kept for the submain pressure changes and discharge variation. So for the 2.1 LPS dripper at 50 centimeter, on the 0% slope, we can have around 88 meters of drip line length. If the slope is 1%, that is going uphill, we can go up to 73 meters. If the slope is 2% uphill, then we can have maximum 59 meters of drip line length. If the slope is down the hill, 1%, then we can have 101 meters of drip line length. And if the slope is 2% down the hill, then we can have 112 meters of emitting pipe length. So in our case, we will assume as 0% slope and we will allow up to 88 meters. This is the chart which explains the 10-20 rule in case of non-pressure compensated drippers. To have the uniform distribution of water, we will allow maximum 10% discharge variation or maximum 20% pressure variation within the shift areas. To have that, we can have around 2.4 meter pressure difference between the last emitting pipe, the last dripper, and at the manual valve. The maximum pressure variation can be 2.4 meter. Now this is the arrangement proposed. We have four shifts. So sub main is placed at the center of the field to have less than 88 meter on each side. The manual valves are placed at the center of the sub main, and each sub main has two flush valves at the ends. The flow rate of each plot is calculated as 23.6 meter cube per hour. Each shift is having 2.5 acre area, and we know the application rate. So based on the application rate and shift area, the flow is calculated. For the flow rate, now as manual valve is placed at the center of sub main, so the flow is divided on sub main. So around 12 meter will be going on one side, left side, and 12 meter will be going on the right side. So the sub main can be of small size as compared to the main line, because the flow is getting divided. So for this given example, the sub main is designed as 63 millimeters, and here you can see the frictional head losses for that particular length as well. These are the final details. Main line is proposed of 90 millimeters and sub main 63 millimeters with all relevant details. This is the pump duty calculations. We have four shifts. Accidentally, this shift areas are same for the all the shifts, but the mainline head losses are different. So the total head calculated for this all the four shifts, and the pump can be suggested for the shift which is having maximum head, that is 43.51 meters for the shift 2, and the flow rate is 23.6 meter cube per hour, that is 6.56 LPS, and head is 43.51 meter for the shift 2. So we can suggest this is the pump selection. 44 meter is the total head and 6.8 LPS discharge, so we can suggest pump KDS852++, which is having suction side of 65 millimeters, delivery side of 50 millimeters, and it is 7.5 HP pump. Irrigation data: design is done for the sugarcane drip irrigation system. Drip line 16008, dripper spacing 0.5 meters, 2.1 LPH dripper discharge. Distance between the rows is 1.8 meter. That itself is the lateral to lateral spacing. Then the application rate is 2.22 millimeters per hour. Maximum discharge or the shift flow is calculated as 23.61 meter cube per hour. Peak water requirement is considered as 7 millimeters per day. Number of shifts or number of operations 4. Maximum discharge variation on a drip line is 7.5%. Daily duration is 12 hours and water source is well. So all the irrigation data will be given on the final design plan. This is the operational schedule. We have four shifts, each of 2.5 acre. Flow rate of each shift is 23.6 meter cube per hour, and each shift will be operated for 3 hours to have total 12 hours operation in a day. So this is the tabular form of operational schedule. This is about the bill of material. Crop is sugarcane, total area is 10 acres, 40,470 meter square. The drip line spacing or row to row spacing is 1.8 meter. Total length of the lateral is calculated as 22,483 meters. And this is about the pipe quantities, pipe bomb. We need to calculate pipe as per design. So here the 63 millimeter total length is 282 meters and 90 millimeters main line is 305 meters. And this is the combined bomb, which includes head control unit, that is the filter, along with other safety equipments like vacuum breaker, the fertilizer tank, non-return wall, the pressure gauge. Then we need to have the main lines, that is 90 millimeter. The submain, that is 63 millimeters, along with manual wall, flush wall, all these small units. Then we need to have the emitting pipes, emitting system, that is drip line 16008 2.1 lph, 22,800 meters. Along with that, we need to have the plain lateral, then start connectors, grommets, end plugs, nipple, etc. So this is the complete BOM for this particular example. Thank you. For more details, you can contact us or write to me for the further information. Thank you.